So we kind of talked about it when we first created the channel a bit, and we were like, what do we do about the internet style comments? And we were like, I bet we can use them. I bet we can use them and then just remove them and detach from them. And we had an experience with like these real asshole people online for a while in 2021, I want to say. When we first reached out and found a community online, found some awesome, amazing fucking people who we are so lucky to know. And we found some really highly narcissistic and abusive people. And they did, like, one system in particular did some really abusive, trash things that were really disgusting. And Vince found ways to respond to what they were doing in a way that just healed us by, like, when what they said triggered pain in us, he'd use it as a map instead of becoming like avoidant of what we were feeling or darting out to attack them. He'd tell them to fuck off, disengage, and then come straight back to us and go, what was just triggered? What's this from? What's happening in me? And there was such a, like, that was life changing. That he learned to do that was life changing. And it really gave us the freedom to be able to respond. That's like where we started looking at our family and our abusers and being like, what got triggered? Where is it from? And we started working out like the real core deep shit in our life. And we started responding to it on that level and making demands of our abuser and then telling them to go fuck themselves and then reporting them to the police and then dealing with all of that. It started because of all of us learning how to come back to us. And it started with Vince learning how to do that from people trying to hurt us. I think at the time, out of pure spite, maybe not pure spite, because there's a lot to that. Definitely spite was an element. But to be able to be like, fuck you're trying to hurt me. I'm gonna use what you're doing to heal. But like to actually do it in a way that helped us was fucking mesmerizing, and I hadn't stopped thinking about it. We started working out how spiteful healing like actually kind of works and how we'd utilize it going forwards. And this was one of our many discussions of like, well, every time somebody tries to hurt us and take our power, we can use the very real power we have over how we respond and how we treat each other and how we see each other to actually replenish ourselves and heal from the experience, to notice what's being pointed out to us, and to tend to those wounds instead of attacking the people that reopened them, because that person's really irrelevant. Like, comparatively, what is relevant is what's happening for us and how we respond, and especially like what's happening for the kids in our system. As adult parts, our job really is to be here with us to sustain what's happening, to witness it, to feel it, to support each other through it, and to make sure that the kids in here don't face it alone. and don't have to take control for our safety below a conscious registry because we're not doing anything, or because we're swept along with it too, or because what we're doing is actually abandoning them in a different way, even if it's by attacking the person who caused it, you know? Like, it's just the start of this entirely new way of working out how to respond. And we figured that, like, you know, we're on the internet, it's gonna happen. We're gonna get comments that are gonna be shit. We just are. People are gonna judge everything we do because people all have their own shit, and people will misunderstand, and people will project their own disowned experiences and rejected, disowned emotions at us, and then judge them at a safe distance using us as the mirror. And like, it's got fuck all to do with us, it's just, it's gonna happen a lot. So like, how are we going to deal with it? And this is how. And we haven't had to do it a lot because actually, like, most of the people on our channel are really, really fucking nice. And it's been like, it's been really wholesome, actually. And there's been so many experiences of like real genuine human to human connection of people meeting us in our pain, us meeting them in theirs. And that is the main experience of people commenting on our channel, which I'm fucking profoundly amazed by and grateful for, especially because so many people that comment on our channel are trauma survivors as well. The fact that we are, the fact that they are, and that, like, this is how we all choose to connect to each other and respond. Not only in spite of what we've gone through, but I think because of it. Like, not because of our experiences, it's not like our experiences made us this way, that can fuck off. No, we did. We did, in spite of what hell we've been through. We took a look at it and we went, I'm not gonna fucking be like that. I'm not gonna make this world worse. And every single amazing fucking system and survivor and person who watches our channel and supports us and supports each other and comments in a way that is altruistic and authentic and compassionate and supportive is choosing to make the world a better place. And if they have to lift the absolute fucking tons of weight of all the counteracting experiences of trauma and abuse that they've lived through to do it, that is just even more fucking powerful and amazing. And we're really grateful and impressed to be a part of that kind of a community and space. You're all fucking amazing. All of you, like, every single person in this system, future us, every single person that comments on our channel, all of our friends, our amazing boyfriends, everybody who chooses to respond by putting something better into the world than what they've had to go through or seen happen. That's real power. That's where we have control. And that is fucking heroic. And you have every right to feel very proud. I'm feeling that today. I'm feeling really impressed for how we decided to deal with this and how we actually are and how it's working. Because there's been a lot of parts of us that, like, you know, it's not like, do we feel fear about these things? Like, fuck yeah, of course we feel, like, fucking terrified about the idea of, like, what's someone gonna say? What's it gonna make us feel? And, like, how are we gonna deal with that? Because we know we're gonna have to re-experience triggers to some very dark shit and, like, a lot of trauma that we've experienced. But today I kind of feel like that let up a bit, because actually we have more power and more control than I realized in how we feel and how we support each other and how we respond. And we don't just have to sit around and wait for somebody's words to go in core deep and trigger these deep, deep wounds while we sit unable to, like a ghost observing our experiences. Trauma makes you feel very much like that's the case, but it's not. We can't control our emotions, like they're there. They have every right to be there. But it doesn't mean giving our power to anyone else. Because I think real power is in being able to fully accept what we feel and where it comes from, and to welcome the parts of us holding it, to be able to sit with it. And then it metabolizes through our body. We don't have to like dwell on what a comment said, or even read it. It's like half of the one I deleted earlier, I don't know what it fucking said. I only felt the trigger from the first couple of lines, and I went, oh, trash, delete it, and came back to us. My defensive programming wanted to like hyper-focus on what it said and try and remember what it said so that I could change our behavior. And you know, those are pathways that I've run since childhood, so there is some work in catching them and going, I get why this is the impulse. It doesn't mean this person has had any influence on us. It means that the adults around us growing up were cunts and we did whatever we had to do to adapt to survive the situation. Now that defensive programming gets triggered by whoever triggers it now with anything our brain perceives as potentially similar to that danger. It's a fucking amazing testament to how adaptive we are and how much we can survive. And we're safe now. We've got real strength and real support inside our system and outside of it, and we can choose to do stuff that's very different. It's okay that these processes start to go off. There's no shame in that either. That's just an amazing survival mechanism. I'm appreciative of how it was created to keep us alive. It worked, we're alive. Now, it's not the best way to respond for our health and our benefit, and we have other ways that are better that we can respond. So we're going to do those instead, we're going to learn to do those instead. And it's okay that the learning process takes a while, because we're literally rewriting and rewiring neural pathways in our brain, like, you know, water entrenching a groove through rock. It's going to take a little while to stop the flow going through the entrenched pathway and entrench a different one. It might be really hard at first. That doesn't say anything about who we are as people, or who they are as people, or like how much power they have or how much power we have. It's just neurobiology. It just says more to what was done to us in childhood and how we survived it. Shame will try to lie to us and internalize some blame or fault, something that make it mean something as a story in our head. But if we stay in our bodies with it, and we're compassionate and understanding with ourselves, and we give ourselves permission to not feel forced to extend compassion or understanding to people who in their actions to us have not earned it, then this all just got a hell of a lot simpler for me. Allowing ourselves and accepting what we feel, that it's there without judging it, that fucking helps. It's easy to know the theory and the words, but to finally start to feel it as an embodied sensation, it's really different. Really much lighter. I've actually felt moments of happiness and I've sighed a lot today. It's been a lot of grief, but relief as well. And I've had a constant headache right across there, as I always do. And I felt really confused as well before recording this. I felt very like everything was a lot and I felt very lost, but in a very overwhelmed way. But we've been doing such different things and such cool dynamics today that I see why. I'm so exhausted now. Oh my god, I'm so exhausted. I collapse.